Hello again. I'm waiting for the spring to come. But I've just when I started this recording, I was thinking that I'm not 100%, but 90% sure that when we come to heaven, we can choose when we have the nicest time on earth, in what age we have the best time. Maybe that we are not going to choose it by ourselves, but God knows when we had it. And I tell you that this is my best time. I have never had such so beautiful life. When I gave birth to my children, I'd had problems with our fathers. Yes, I had different fathers on them, because God didn't come and talk to me before I was 48, so I was done with my children, and I had very bad fathers to them, and that's why they are so bad, my kids, so they don't care about me, and my son really hate me and work against me like a devil, against me in everything. And the sad thing is that he have my grandkids, and I am not allowed to see them or talk to them. They are gone in my life, but I am used with it already from the start. Was I not allowed to see my grandkids? So the devil, he don't understand that it will be if it take some years, that longing for my grandkids is going away more and more for each years, and that's nothing that I am thinking about every day. He think that I should go and cry every day, the devil, that I should longing and be sick because of, and maybe die also. Of course he want me to die away from everything. He don't want to see me, my son. And he hate me so much. And because he is the devil, in him I have seen the devil coming out from my son. And he was so bad as a kid, and I lived together with my daughter's father, but we couldn't have him at home because he could do so much bad things, and he was going sexual on our daughter. My daughter is born 10 years after my son, so he was 10 years old when she came to this world, and that triggered the evil side of him, so I could never have him alone with my daughter any time. And sometimes we did some video videos on the kids, and I could see after, when you record something, you are inside the camera. You are not, you don't see everything. But then when you start to play what you have recording, you can see things that is not good. And my daughter was a little child, so little, so we were not with other people, but in our garden she didn't have any pants on. It was so she could be healed from the diapers. So sometimes she had nothing on her, and she sit there, and we make a movie on the kids, and after I see that he planted in ants that come in the grass. I took the ants and place it inside my daughter, between her legs. These evil things. And she have always been frightened about balloons, because she maybe was 2 years old when he come and had a balloon, and he said, look, a balloon, and come close to her face, and then he have a needle, and it blow up the balloon with this big sound. So she have always been frightened about balloons now. So I could see sometimes that he sit and whisper in her ear, like the devil, you know, he's whisper in the ear. And we couldn't take it, because everything was about have control over what he did the whole time. And when we say something, we would go angry at him. Like one winter time when it was very much snow, he ran out nude, out in the snow, and ran to our neighbor. So it was an old man, maybe 80 years old, and he knocked on his door, and there he's standing nude in the snow. And so we couldn't take it. So we ask for help, and so he come to a foster home, and so we could relax and be a pretty normal family. But it was not normal, as my daughter's father was not nice at all. When it come to sexual things, what I started with to talk about in this recording was that I have the best time in my life ever. So that means that it doesn't need to be young people or children in heaven. It's every age, because God knows when we have that most happiest time. And he wants us to live an everlasting life, happy and joyful. So he don't take from scratch someone that is in very, very bad condition and come there. And when I talk about this, yes, no, because there is a spirit coming, I feel it, and... it teach me now that I didn't understood this, that God take many people, that we are going to be in heaven when, if you have been in an accident, and you maybe cut off your legs, and then God take you in that time before the accident, in the age when you were running free with both legs. And someone here that listen at this now, I know it, because the spirit that is here is telling me that I'm talking to someone here that don't have the legs functional. It's maybe not cut off, but it doesn't work, your legs. But you are going to run there, and it's coming this knowledge that it's not about to get a new body. It's sometimes it have to be a new body, but it's that you are going to be in that time when your body was without any disease or disable. They are going to take you back to where you are born with both legs and arms and mental okay, and then also, of course, the best time in your life, even if you have legs and mental okay. But so that it's not really bringing you a new body. The spirit is talking. I'm glad, but it'd be so much for me also to understand that it's about the body that is not need to be a body, a new recreation. Is what it take, because in heaven there is no time, so that there is no time limit, so they can go back to a time where you had your legs, where you had your arms, where you were without any cancer, without any brain damage and these things. It's a very nice message for the spirit. It's so, I think it's God that is talking here, because there I don't see any spirit, a person here. We're coming from up from over my skull, and that means it's God that's talking. So he is telling you that what he's telling you is about that we should not be angry at our body that we have just now, because it's going to be that body you had before everything bad happened. So it's it's gonna be like you look the same as you were in that time, and that I'm talking to God about this, because it's doesn't really fit into what I have talking about, that with this that your it's right that I have talked about, but I have not understood everything of it, that your mother can be a little girl that come into you in heaven, but that means also that have with the body to do, that she have going back to that time where she was most happy, and where she have the body was free from everything that was bad, that was belonged to earth. That body that belonged to earth doesn't exist in heaven. If it was, it's very few that have a perfect body on earth when we're leaving earth to heaven. So it still can be a different age on us where in heaven. So that's fit in what I have got. I have got the knowledge about, but I didn't see this way of understanding that they don't rebuild a body for you in heaven. They take a body you already had that was in perfect condition in one time. And if you didn't have it when you were born without any arms or legs, you're gonna get a new body. But that's only some people that get it. So it's an interesting knowledge, very interesting knowledge I got there here. No, thank you, God. He's on here, and he tell me to go on what I was thinking I should talk about. It's many things that have happened since last time I recorded, and it is about heaven. This also a message I got on Sunday, and in heaven is an order, but that also is directed to earth, that everything is there for a reason. We're talking about that. Some things happen for a reason, but we don't really understand what that means, that everything happened for a reason. But that's in a kind of order from heaven, step by step, to take you somewhere, it's bad to only say it, like only to say it. It's really means something, that everything is. It's already done in heaven, in order for you to walk in God's plan for your life. But then we are, many of us is disobedient, and many are stubborn. I forget the word. I'm old, so I forget sometimes. And that's about to be a saint. It's a calling. We can call it a calling in order. The calling is to walk in God's plan for us, and that is not something that that man should give you. It is given from God, and it doesn't matter if you don't need to be in a church building. You can be by yourself and still get the calling from God. God doesn't call you into a church. He can call you in to be a speaker somewhere, in an event that is not about the church. And he can call you for to do things, action, on what he tell you to do. And that I understand it, because when I was in United States, and I had no money, I was robbed from all the money I saved up money for, to buy me an airplane ticket, I was very sick, and I should have died if I have not coming back to Sweden. So suddenly, just after I was robbed, suddenly I got the call from my daughter's father that doesn't believe in God. But he has called me and say, he didn't know that I had been robbed from all my money. But he called me and he said to me that I'm going to send you an airplane ticket. He said to me, I lived and work with Muslim people in the house, so I have an address for him to send me an airplane ticket. So he did. And that this is action that God call you for, and it doesn't need. It's like a temporary. Now is God is on me now, because it's like telling me that I'm talking right things. What he does, God, it's not. You hear me that you don't need to be in a church building, in any religious relationship or this, because God can use you. He even used the devil sometimes. So he make my daughter's father think about that my daughter should not lose her mother. He knew that I didn't have any money, I had no home and like that. And he didn't want me to be killed in United States, dead in far away from my daughter. So God have placed that in his heart, that he need to give me a ticket. So that's what I got. And it doesn't matter that he had a calling on him in that moment, that when he buy a airplane ticket for me and send it, he did. He act on what God was telling him to do. And so that there is two ways of calling, a temporary calling, and then also a calling for too long do a service, a long calling where to work in God's will, and not about only to stop at Jesus. I hear it so many times that people talking about the gospel of Jesus, the Jesus gospel, but Jesus have a calling on him. Jesus have a calling on him to walk around in this world and to first to educate disciples to understand what he was talking about, and then he walk around and talk about God's kingdom. That's the gospel. That's the main gospel. It's not Jesus' gospel about Jesus, how he walk around. That's not the gospel we should spread. That's not what I'm spread today in my podcast. I spread about God's kingdom, heaven. And heaven is, that's why heaven know that I'm serious to talk about God's kingdom. I have a little hard to speak just now because it's so much on me of spirits. And it's God. I think he's talking soon with you. I'll take a little water first. He want to talk. And there's it's about this to hold against the door to heaven. It's God talking now. He wants to talk to you. It's to hold against my kingdom. To hold the door so that it never will open. When you listen in the church and those preachers that standing in the road, in the streets, street preacher that want you only to listen about Jesus, that Jesus is everything, that and like it's a fence between Jesus and heaven, and they don't want you to come closer to me. So they, and it's not their fault. It's only they talking and teach what they know. That's the only thing they know. They grew up like that. The parents was telling them this. The church where they were going telling them this, that Jesus is God, and Jesus is the only way to look at, and behind Jesus they never see it. Jesus is only the way to heaven in what he is talking about, but it's the word of Jesus that you should receive, not what he is doing. When he's walking around, it's his teaching in words. that you need to understand. Not the other things that have nothing with heaven to do. It's only what Jesus received from God that is the main thing. This is God is talking. That's why my voice changed in this way. I feel very old and a man, like a man now. It's fun. If you understand this, you should look at a Bible that have this blue-colored letters. The text is blue where Jesus is talking. And that's the only thing you should learn. The other things is only what we call bread text. It's only belong to the story that is only in the shadow of what he's talking about. Do you understand? God is showing me a picture, and the picture is about, it's a thick Bible you have. It doesn't matter how nice it looks like, the Bible. If you don't have that blue or red letters in your Bible where Jesus is talking, he showed me in a picture that you can close that book you have, because that give you nothing. It's not about Jesus you are going to talk about, read about. It's what Jesus is talking about. Oh, nothing matters of the other things. It's only history. And it's a command from God that you should go and fix this. And those letters, blue and red letters, there is on the internet some places where they have it. But mostly is it in old Bibles from the 70s, like that. And it should be the difference between God and God. The big letter for me, God, and small letters for Jesus Christ when he's talking. Jesus when he's talking. That's a Bible you should have. That's the real Bible. Not those other fake Bibles that they give you today. And I'd be very angry when they give you or you buy only the New Testament and read it. Because everything belongs to the Bible. Also the Old Testament. It should be both Old and New Testament. It should also hold in blue or red letters where Jesus is talking. And it should hold that God is written in big letters. That's so you know the difference when God is talking and when those small gods is talking, because there is many small gods, and that's those small gods is also sent to Eva in in her episodes. Those are small gods. Let's see. He say that I can move on in what I should talk. It's not be like I was thinking it should be. That it's never be, because the spirit is in every episode, almost every episode. And I have to bring them out and talk, let them talk. And so it was to be as a little child, and that doesn't mean that kind of child that you that is going to school or like that. It's a very young child. To be like a child, you know, a newborn baby, it can't do anything if it doesn't get help. If it's in need the whole time for other people to action, to feed it and to wash it and only be with it and hold it and these things. It's not that it can stand on its own. And it's very fast a little child become a part of this world. So it must be a very young child God is talking about. And before, when it's very in innocence, before it have learned the hard life, it's before that, when it's everything it sees, it's curious about what it see, and you know, it sometimes the small kid is stop things in their mouth for to feel it if it's good to eat, like what it is, this kind. So small baby is it about, because we should be meek and humble and trust. We learn very fast to not trust. We learn to very fast to have no faith in anything. To more and more we go in and see the negative. But before that we should be go back just when we are born. And Jesus is saying, but Jesus was in the spirit, and in his spirit he received from God. And so that's God is talking. When Jesus is saying something, it's from God. And he say that we should receive the little child. And that means also that we should receive ourselves to come back to ourselves and love ourselves. Love yourself. It's not selfish things. To love yourself is to want the best for you, but not to take it from other people. It's only to serve yourself, but not steal from other people or place them under you. It's only to be here and now in your love yourself. And then is it to try to love the people that you meet also? You don't need to really love in that way, but you should accept everyone. And now I'm coming now to talk about what I really wanted to talk about with you in this episode. It was my family tree, my research. And first I come to the tribe of Benjamin in Israel. I knew I did DNA, and I have 25% Jewish DNA, but I didn't know where it was. But I found out it yesterday that I belong to. On Sunday, yesterday, and I belong to Benjamin tribe, and I'd be surprised because it was on my father's side. I was the whole time thinking that my mother's lineage should come there, but it was my father's, and it's going down the whole way. And I was thinking, first, I have talking to you in another episode that it was the man that gave his grave, his thumb to Jesus' body, that wealthy man there. But it wasn't, because I think it will be when I go to my mother's lineage that I come to him. But on my father's lineage, I come to Jesus. I'd be surprised that I belong to Abraham and to Jesus. And I come down to Enoch and the whole. I was, what? I saw first it was some apostles, and then I was thinking that's Jesus' brothers I come to, and then I come to Mary, and then I really Mary of Jacob's. I didn't know that she belonged to the Jacob family, but now I know it, and I'd be so very surprised. And then I could go deeper and to Abraham, and it was no problem at all with my father's lineage. It go very quick down to Mary. It was not much gap. It was some names that was only names and not the years where they were when they lived. But that was only a few times. It was one person that had no age, no year. But the name was there, reported, written up. So that was I have no doubt about it, that it was going very straight down in that lineage. But then when I find it, I It was hard already when I find out that I belong to all the royals in Europe, and not far away. They say that everyone that is born in Europe, they belong to royals after 900 years, like that. But mine was, my grandmother was royal family, and so that was very fast I got, and people envy this. It's very hard to find out. It's so sad that they envy when I have this royal. I get many emails from people that do research and say that I have error in my research, and they don't understand because they are from United States, and they don't understand really the European history, and they think I am, that I live in United States, so they think I don't know anything. So I have to tell them I live in Sweden. I grew up in Sweden. I know my country. I know the countries around me. I know Europe. So I have to tell them. But it seems like they go angry, because I have never had so much now when I have this. After that, I find out that I was related to Queen Victoria of England. Then it started, people. And then I have Joseph Smith as his. I didn't know. I was only looking at the names I got in my research, and then suddenly I didn't know when someone wrote me and say, how can you be related to him? He's Joseph Smith's father's father, grandfather to Joseph Smith, they say. And there was, I have my tree on Family Search, so those people from the Mormon Church, it seems like they go angry at me because I am related to Joseph Smith, and I was wondering how can I be related to these people, but I see it just today, for about 2 hours ago, I find a man, that Swedish man. He was a pastor in Sweden, and then he has Smith as a last name. And he was Swedish names in everything, and he lived in my area where I was born. So it was no doubt that we were related, he and I, because he was born and died also in that area where I was born. And then I follow his Smith. Why do you have that name, Smith? So it's going back to England. Everything is about England. And he is I don't really know now, but about like my fourth grandfather's two wife of someone. of my first cousin, was it? And I have not checked it out how it is. But their kids will be related to me also. So that's, I try to find it out, but I have in my family tree, I have 183 Smith. So it's hard to know the lines there. But one day I will find it. My most important was to find out where my roots are coming from. And the roots are from Mary, from Abraham. And no wondering, I get these spirits coming and talking to me because they are related to me. I have said that in other episodes that those spirits that is coming here to me, they are related in some way with me. And then I find out that it's not in a Christian thinking, believe that, but there is God have a wife. I didn't know that, but in other religion it is that he had a wife, and her name was Asherah, and she was killed because those men wanted only a man to be God. They didn't want a woman to be God. So that's it was I think it was 2005. I know I have talking about it before, but it was I have this vision dream. A woman come to me, and she was like, she showing me she was higher up because there was full of men under her, almost like they lift her up. And she say to me, seek who I am. And that I know today that is Asherah. And then someone say to me that she was saying that you should look, seek yourself. And that's what I think now. It's not that I'm proud of it. I don't want it, you to see it like I brag. But I feel like I am Asherah. And it was someone saying that to me, that I don't know where this person come from. But that person say that, seek who I am. It's about you. So that's, I have come into that point now that I know that I am Asherah, because my whole life men have wanted to kill me. It have not been about women. The only woman that I wanted to kill me is my adopted sister, and that's, she is adopted into the family to destroy me. But all my life have it been men tried to destroy me, like Asherah was killed outside the temple, and because the man wanted, it's only man that is going to be in this world that have decide what we should do and not to do. And that was what God was telling me from the first start in the United States. He come one morning and say to me that don't make any decision upon what man is telling you. And that I understand now today that it was more than only to listen at God and not listen at man. But that was also that men try to change me. And man is trying to divide me from God. And I have hold what he have told me. I have hold it in 20 years now. That I not make any decision about what man is telling me. It doesn't matter what it cost me to not do what man want me to do. It doesn't matter that I sit by myself and I have never been accepted to a church. I have never been allowed to preach more than in Africa. And because in Africa it was about money that I could. But it was, first it have to be all the men have to preach in the African church. Then the last one that could preach, it was me, because I was a woman. So it was still there, that men, because people was tired, they go away. So not half of the church was there, because the man was talking for 2 hours and then they have to go home and eat or feed their kids or like that. And so that was man also dominating. So I say that God can't wait. If God wants to talk, he must could talk in your church, I say to them. I can't sit and wait when God is talking to me that I should talk to the people, to the church. But they let me do it, and it was very frustrating to not could tell them what God was talking about, because it's sensitive. It have to do it immediately. They can't wait. When God is talking, it have to be now, and not 1 hour from now. I can take God away a little for some seconds to speak what I had in my heart, and he let me do it. But it's our relationship we have. But I could never let God waiting 1 hour. Like in Africa, I was, and it was gone. What they had told me, it have to be now, here and now. So, and this recording in the episode is different every time. It's I can't know what's going to happen. And I was thinking there was not much to talk about. It's going to be a short talking. But when the Spirit's coming, it will be a long episode anyway. Whatever I think. It changed as soon as I start recording. It have been since 2015. You can go to the YouTube channel also and watch me. It have been since 2015. my first video, I say, I don't know, but I heard God wanted me to record a video, but I don't know what will happen. And after only some second, God come through and talked in the video. So I never know when I'm working not in my own will. Like Jesus, he didn't work in his own will. Both Jesus and I, Jesus, my cousin, my brother, he was talking from God, and I am talking from God. I do what I'm talking about when I say talking from God. I mean that I do his will, God's will. And then I can talk other things, but I come to that time when God wants to say something more. He's on me now again. He said that I have a message for someone that listened to this. He said, he's on here now. It's a woman he wants to talk to. And it seems like he say that he is talking about Hannah. Hannah. Slovakia. He's talking about Slovakia and Hannah. So they can, if you're from Slovakia, it can be, maybe I don't pronounce it right, Hannah, but that's what it's talking about. It's a, he say that you are not on that spot where you should be. It's a, he showing me that you're holding a bucket, and you are working a hard worker with your body. You are going to burn you out in this job, and God doesn't want you to be that way. And he's showing me some mountain also in the background, and you're standing in the shadow of a door. And it's when he's showing that door, it's this decision to make. If you want to go into the darkness, or if you're staying out in that, you just know you are standing in the light, but there is a shadow of a door. So that means that something is open there that is not good for you. So that's a warning for you to not take that road and the path, and it have nothing with money to do, he say. They trick you with the money to go into the darkness. He's I ask him what can she do when she is there. He say that there is you have relatives that have seen your situation, and there it doesn't need to be that you're working in that way. But you are a hard worker. You should not take it literally. You are a hard worker, and there is a shortcut to take that is about money and then you go into the darkness and you be lost. So that's not a way to go. God is telling you that. And there is a light, a landscape that is light. And there, not so far away from you, there is relatives that bring you in. If you only call them, they will help you, because they know what you're going through. So it's talking about drugs here now. So that's, you can go deeper down, but just now is you're in the edge of going in and be lost in the darkness. So that's what God is telling you to call. You have help in some. There is, he's showing me that is a little old woman. It's hard to know the age of people. But she maybe is 50, 60 years old. And she's like a mother figure. She's like we see it, a little thick woman, not a slim one. It's a real picture of a mother figure we want to go to and hug and be together with. She baking cakes and doing all everything to cuddle you and loving you. And she's only waiting for you to come home. Come home to her. Because you are so welcome. You're so welcome. No, you don't need to feel like guilt. She don't have that feeling about you. She know what's going on. But she receive you anyway. She take you, as I say from the beginning, it's very strange that every time what I talking about in the beginning will be in the other way in the end of the episode. What I was talking about to receive the child. That's what I be so humble. I be almost so I cry because I didn't know it was about that from the beginning. It was for you, Hannah. It was you from Yugoslavia. No, Slovakia, was it? So that was for you, in love from God, to send you this message. Thank you, God. Thank you. You're welcome, he said. So polite. It was fun. Thank you for listening, Anna. God loves you. You hear it. God loves you so much. And one day, you that waiting for a message, one day that message will come to you. And I hope that you get the message, even if there is not a name in this, that you receive words that is saying in this, that you feel like this is for me, then take it in and pondering that in your heart. I love you also. And God loves you more. Thank you for listening.